about that time, you know.
Tick tock.
On the all out show. You know? Yeah. Once again, Root Jew, Lord Sear. Shit. Check it, y'all.
Time keeps on slipping, 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 slipping.
Time to turn on the radio. It's the all-out show. Come on, hoes, put your hands in the air. It's the Lord Sear. Rockin' what I want with Rude Jude over there. Out in L.A. on the west. All the hair on his chest, coat smelling like a mess. Lord Sear in New York. Never eaten pork. Wanna fuck that bitch. She said no. That's fucked up. Oh, well, shit. What I'm gonna do with this poor ass bitch? I'ma give her a radio, but on shape for a flip. The all-out show, it'll become well-equipped. With all the shit that we like to say, Monday through Friday before the 8. We like to chill on now and hang with dragons, fly through the air. We know what's happening. It's the all out show. Put your hands in the air. It's the time to be on, y'all.
All around the building, you know what I mean?
Yes, indeed. We got the show, we got the song, we got what you need. Yes, y'all. Don't stop. Keep on. Check us out right now. Turn on the radio. 888-742-3345 is Lord Sear, Rude Jude. We got KC on the boards. We got the beat going.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? All out show.
What?
Yo, what's wrong with y'all, man?
Yeah.
Let's start it off.
Come on.
Let's go.
Go.
Scooby doo doo. What's up, man? It's fucking Tuesday, bro.
It's a Tuesday. The best show on the radio.
Yeah, ever. The best show ever.
With an E.
Yeah. I guess. We both sound real hype.
Like, where does hype come from? Oh,
no. We got to, you know what? Hey, I just spent the last hour doing an interview. Okay. I want to shout out Eric Lacey from mlive.com. It's a website for Michigan. Can I just say I've been in entertainment for 16 years, and this is the first time a Michigan publication has ever even fucking interviewed me.
You serious?
16 years I've been doing shit. This is the first interview I've ever had. So thank you, Eric. For fucking, I feel like Susan Lucci. Like, I'll never win shit. So thank you for fucking breaking that goddamn that slump.
That barrier.
That was some slump buster shit. I appreciate you, dude. Fucking
that's
A.
What's up, man.
Yeah. No, it fucking is. And he's just a listener to the show. He listened to the show. He was like, hey, I just want to interview you because you're from Michigan and you do a good show at Shade 45. I was like, fucking hey, dude. He said, we got a million viewers every day. I was like, I don't give a fuck if you had 50.
Yeah.
I'm just happy someone from Michigan hit me up because goddamn knows I'll be repping the fuck out of Detroit and Flint and all that other shit.
You don't want to play that Flint shit. Fuck a Flint.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Whatever. But yo, right now I'll do a fucking, I don't care if you got a blog with 3 people that do it, I'll do an interview on your blog. I don't give a fuck. I'm doing that shit. I'll talk to anybody. If you got more than 10 Twitter followers and a blog, I'll do your fucking blog. I don't care. I'll do whatever. For real. Get at me. Eric Lacey laced me. This is what we got. I was thinking for the Takeover Tuesday, like, since it is the new year and people have been saying Happy New Year, Happy New Year, you know, they're really stretching this shit. But, like, what if we do, like, the, you know, the new year, like, new, the new mix, like, new beginnings. Mm-hmm. Maybe songs from artist's first album. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do artist's early work.
Oh, okay. I see
for
what
New
saying.
Year.
Right. Like it was a Nas halftime.
Totally. Party and Bullshit by Biggie.
Oh, all right.
Eminem, fucking Infinite, or even maybe like an unreleased, one of them unreleased early freestyles.
Yes.
Yes.
That type of shit. Jay-Z when he's rapping all fast.
Oh, yeah. The originators, yeah. Yes. Yes, that's...
For the new year.
Because everybody's still like, yo, still happy new year, man. Happy new year. You lost weight? Fuck with you. Like, fuck you, bitch.
You just can't lose weight in a day. Just, like, motherfucker said he's going to lose weight. He ain't going to lose it tomorrow. It's a process.
I'm like, thank you.
That's the thing, like, you know, if you're in a cycle of doing some shit, the only way to get out of that is to stop doing whatever the fuck you're doing. Mm-hmm. So if you're in a cycle of fucking, you know, putting on weight, the only way to stop that is to adjust whatever the fuck you're doing. Mm-hmm. So just, yo, you might not be losing weight, but get a salad today. You know what I'm saying? That's how you do it. And then you get a salad tomorrow. Toss a salad the day after that.
Huh?
You'll be fucking skinny in no time.
Excuse me?
There's no calories in eating asshole, Sear. You could eat all the asshole you want. There's no fucking calories.
If that's what you like to do, that's what's up.
Yeah. I'll eat the fuck out of a girl's asshole. I'll do that shit on the first date. I'm white. I don't give a fuck, bro. She can go jogging first. I don't care. I'm gross. I don't care. I'm gross. Hey, I'm serious about these interviews. Hit me up on Twitter. Rude_Jude. Fucking get at me, dog.
It's good shit. Uh-huh.
Yeah, we actually got a Detroit rapper on here that's going to be doing a Hater Love It.
Oh, shit.
Ty Ferris.
Okay. Oh, shit. Psychic Hotline.
Are we doing Psychic Hotline?
Oh, man. That's yeah, that'll be fun. Something, man. Ooh, what a Tuesday. And then we got Sam with the news.
Doing the news. From the throat. Sammy Man Throat.
Oh, come on, man. Then we got the drunk mix, man. Might do the Funk Soul Edition, part 5. Mm. Funk Soul, all Funk right. Soul. Oh, what the hell? How cold is it out there where you at, man?
It's, I don't know, it's like 70 degrees. I wouldn't even say that's cold. It's more warm. How warm is it out there?
Yo, B, it broke records today. It's 7 hours.
You know, my mom was telling me in Michigan it was like negative 15.
No!
Zero.
No. No crime, please. Oh, there ain't no crime out there, man.
Crime. It's too fucking cold for crime. But you know what my mom what did do? She knows some trick because she used to live up north. You like boil some water, right? You take boiling water, you go outside, and then you throw the pot out into the air and the water just vaporizes.
Yes, I've seen some shit like that on YouTube, and then people got burnt.
Yeah, I guess people are getting fucked up.
Like, what the fuck?
Yeah. People are getting fucked up. Yeah.
Damn, man.
All right. What else is there? Is that it? Is that all?
Let's play some
music. Is that all?
That's all. Let's play some music, man. It's the All Out Show. Rude Jew Lord Sip. Call up, man.
Shout out to Eric Goldman. He'll eat a girl's ass, too. That's fucking A. He's a slim guy. You should start doing what we doing, Sear.
Oh,
you that asshole, buddy.
Don't get it. And he's gonna play this show.
I'ma go get it. Whoa, whoa, ho, ho. What's up, people?
Hey.
Hey there, everybody. So this is all over the news right now. Sear was just listening to it, and I thought it was.
Sear, you guys watching wrestling? God,
I thought you were watching like old wrestling videos on YouTube when they get to talking shit and they're like, I'm gonna tell you something, Mean Gene. I'm going down there. Yo, Jake the Snake Roberts thinks that he's the best DDT artist. I'm gonna show him who's the best. I'm gonna DDT his fucking asshole. Like, I thought that's what you was listening to. And I was like, yo, what is that? And it was Dennis Rodman arguing with some dude off of CNN, Chris Cuomo. Is it Cuomo? Cuomo.
Come on.
I'll just say
Cuomo. Come on. I can't. Hey, I'm right with you, man.
I get, yo, so Dennis Rodman set up has been hanging out in North Korea. And he's setting up this shit to play basketball, like a basketball game.
He's bringing
all over old NBA players, right?
He has Nick Van Exel. It's 10 people. Nick Van Exel, I think, something West. He was nice back then. Bum-ass Nick. I forgot his name. The center. Charles. Oh, God. It's just.
I think I used to have his basketball card. He looked familiar to me. I see who you're talking about.
Yeah.
Can you pull it up, Sam? Can someone pull it up? The list? Who's going to be playing?
Yeah, I'm looking for it right now.
Thank you.
Yeah,
he's got all these fucking dudes. He's doing an interview, and the guy asks him about Kenneth Bay, who is an American that went to North Korea and was arrested, and he's being held. He's been there for like a year, held without charges. And he's asking, and before you guys are like, oh my God, that's crazy. I can't believe that. It's bullshit. Yeah, Guantanamo Bay, people, come on. Don't act like we're better than anyone else. Let's be real. Let's not act like we just don't snatch motherfuckers up and hold on to them forever. It's what governments do. But apparently Dennis Rodman was saying that that he was going to talk to this Korean motherfucker.
Kim Jong-un.
Kim Jong-un.
Wait, what?
I'm so happy I'm bad at these fucking names. That means I haven't been paying attention to the world.
I want Sam to say it again. What's his name?
Kim Jong-un.
Man, you say it like, you don't even say it, man. Kim Jong-un, yeah. Apparently, he's supposed to talk to Kim Jong-un about getting Kenneth Bay released. What did he say, Sam?
He said last May, I'm going to try and get the guy out. It's going to be difficult.
That's baby steps. But then I'm sure Dennis Rodman watched Kim Jong-un kill his own uncle, and he probably was like, you know what, fuck that, I'm not gonna talk to him about shit, I'm just gonna go over here and play this basketball, try to be cool.
Hey man, want to see a three-pointer?
Yeah, it's right there. You want to see me dunk, Kim?
Here we go.
I'm really good at rebounds, check this out. Yeah, let me grab that ball.
Woo!
I actually like the idea of them going over there. We don't use enough diplomacy anymore in this world. It's like, if we got a problem with you, we don't talk to you, and then we just come up with a reason to go blow your ass up. That's all we do. There's no diplomacy.
Yeah.
We don't work it out.
We got the names, man, of the NBA players.
Well, all right, what are they?
Kenny Anderson, Cliff Robinson, Vin Baker, as well as ex-players Craig Hodges, Doug Christie, and Charles D. Smith.
That's who I recognize, Charles D. Smith.
Bum-ass Smith, fucking fat.
That's cool, though. They're going over there. They're going to play basketball. And what a lot of people don't realize is, like, man, I was thinking about this. I was listening to some history shit. Actually, you know what? You know what made me really think about this? When I went overseas while Bush was president and I was trying to fuck hookers in Amsterdam, every time one of them whores found out that I was from America, they started charging me more. Like, oh, you from America? Well, it costs another 10 euros to take off my shirt. Oh, you want to be able to touch my titty? That's another 10 euros. Oh, you want doggy style? That's fucking another 10 euros. And I was like, why are they being so mean to me? And it was because I was an American. And I didn't vote for Bush. I got nothing to do with this dude. I don't even like that motherfucker. So think about these North Koreans like that. Like, hey. They might not fuck with this dude, but that's who they living under. What the fuck are they supposed to do? We are not our governments. We're just some little fucking, we are the peasants that live under all this bullshit. So if Dennis Rodman want to go over there, show these cats that not all Americans are fucking like bloodthirsty assholes.
Yeah.
Then that's fucking awesome. Why do these people keep giving him a hard time? So here's this guy, this smug motherfucker, asking Dennis Rodman some questions. Yeah. And Dennis Rodman totally loses his shit, and he sounds ridiculous. So it goes like this.
You do have a relationship with this man. You've said it many times. We've seen it demonstrated.
Yes.
For whatever reason.
Yes.
Are you going to take an opportunity, right, if you get it,
right,
to speak up for the family of Kenneth Bay and to say, let us know why this man is being held, that this is wrong, that he is sick? If you can help Dennis, will you take the opportunity?
The one thing about politics, Kenneth Bay did one thing. If you understand, I got to get it. If you understand what Kenneth Bay did,
yeah,
do you understand what he did?
What did he do? You
in
tell
this
me.
Country.
You tell me. What did he do?
No. You tell me. You tell me. Why is he held captive?
They haven't released any charges. They haven't released. They haven't released any reason.
Let me do this. I would love to speak on this.
Go ahead.
You know, you got 10 guys here. 10 guys here that have left their families, left their damn families to help this country as a sports venture. Got 10 guys, all these guys here. Do anyone understand that?
We do, and we appreciate that, and we wish them well with cultural exchange.
No. I'm just saying, no, I don't give a shit. I'm just rass ass what the hell you think. I'm saying to you, look at these guys here. Look at them.
Yeah, but Dennis, don't put it on them. Don't use them as an excuse for the behavior that you're putting on yourself.
They came here.
You just basically were saying that Kenneth Bay did something wrong. We don't even know what the charges are. Don't use these guys as a shield for you, Dennis.
Listen.
Ain't no shield. I got it. Let me do this. Really? Really? I'm going to tell you one thing. People around the world, I'm going to do one thing. Your guy behind the mic right now, we are the guys here doing one thing. We have to go back to America and take the abuse. Do you have to take the abuse? What we going to take? Do you, sir? Let me know. Are you going to take the abuse? We're going to get it. But guess what I do? One day, this door is going to open.
That was powerful.
He was able to talk for 2 minutes and not make one fucking lick of sense. Why they do Dennis Rodman? Why y'all keep doing him like that, man? All right, he kind of does it to himself.
He does. That's hard. Come on, man. It's all body. What the fuck are you saying? He's like, oh, no. Oh, let me get this.
I got this. Hold on a second. I got this, motherfucker. Hold on. Let me cook them. Let me cook them. You can eat them later. I got this.
Wait. Hold on. Now, wait a minute. Now, wait. They tried to tell him to be
his
quiet.
Boys was trying to help him. His boys was trying to help him.
Charles Smith was trying to be like, no, wait a minute, man. I went to school. I don't know about you. But let's, hold on now.
Yo, man.
You saw what he had on? He had five earrings in his face. Damn.
Why is this guy got Rodman on there fucking? Why don't you just let him go play basketball for some fucking North Koreans? Why don't you just applaud that?
Let him live, man.
But y'all don't understand. Think about it like a family. You know what I'm saying? Think about it like a family. Maybe you get maybe your sister goes rogue. Maybe your brother gets a little crazy. You cut him off? No, you have your cousin go over there, talk to him, make sure he's good. For the long run. Yeah, we might miss this Thanksgiving, but we'll get him back in two more Thanksgivings.
Damn.
This motherfucker, hold on a second, let me tell you something.
Hold on, I got this.
And he's sitting there holding a cigar arguing, bro.
I'm trying to be cool.
Hold on, oh, this motherfucker, oh, he crazy. Like, talking me any old kind of way.
Why you trying to be so cool for?
Look, you know why he ain't bringing shit up about fucking Kenneth Bay? Because that motherfucker killed his uncle.
Yo, I got nothing. Right, you don't want to do
he
that.
Killed his motherfucking uncle, dog. What the fuck is he going to do to Dennis Rodman? Just let him go over. What do you want him to do? What do you want him to do? Solve shit? Give him the fucking get rid of his nuclear bombs? You want him to do that shit? Let him do what he's good at. Rebounding basketballs. You fucking assholes. I hate them CNN motherfuckers.
And then, he was trying to put words in his mouth going, Dennis, you just said that you helped, oh, that man. You would help him out, that you were there, that you would.
Dude, I think any type of cultural exchange is a good thing for people.
It brings people together.
We always look at these governments, all these, like, yo, I bet you, yo, you go over to fucking Afghanistan and ask these people about Americans. I bet you they hate the fuck out of us.
The way they
you think
murdered.
They're stoked about America? Now, how many of you guys have, you know, what have you got to do with it? Nothing. You ain't had shit to do. You didn't vote none of that shit. You didn't vote for none of that shit to happen. We are not our governments, man. Let Dennis Rodman go play basketball for the people and not bust his goddamn balls about it. Right. Ask him some real questions like, goddamn, Dennis, you old as fuck. Are you afraid of breaking your hip when you go to rebound the basketball, you old motherfucker? Or like, damn, Dennis, I thought you were about to play some ball. Why are you smoking a cigar right now?
Right.
Like, why you Jesse in San Diego.
Yo, what up?
What up, though?
Hey, I just want to catch up on you with saying, man. I went to Hong Kong last year, and obviously, you know, that's, you know, it's part of China, and you know what I'm saying, we was out there, and you know, we was out there walking the streets trying to get a cab ride, man, and the cab drivers would come up to us and see that we was American, and they would turn us down, they yell at us, and they would just drive off like they didn't want to fuck with us whatsoever. We was walking.
What country
the
was that?
In Hong Kong.
See,
which is part of China, you know, And it was just fucked up because, like, you know what I'm saying, we were just trying to get our tourists on, you know what I'm saying, do our thing. And people just knowing that we was American, they would just, you know, they wouldn't give us no service. They wouldn't, you know, let us shop there. The cab driver specifically would not pick us up and take us to where we needed to go. It was fucked up.
Just, yeah, that's what I'm saying, man. Be nice to each other, dog. You know, yeah, be nice. Yeah. Yeah. Someone said Dennis Rodman was drunk. If that's the case, why y'all letting Dennis Rodman do interviews drunk, man?
You're smelling all like liquor and letting him talk like that? That ain't right. I would have told him, why you got all that shit on your face, on them earrings and shit?
If they would have asked me, like, are you going to talk to him about Kenneth Bay? I'd have been like, did you see what the fuck he just did to his uncle? Bro, you talk to him about Kenneth Bay, you bitch. No, I ain't talking about shit. I'm going to play this basketball. I'm going to eat a steak dinner with him. I'm going to fly my ass home.
Keep it 100.
Fuck out of here. All right, man, let's play some music.
Let's do it.
In what might possibly be the most controversial feature on the radio today.
Bitch, don't play that shit on this radio no more.
This is the place where careers are made.
That shit was awesome. I love it.
And broken.
Yeah, what's up, you fucking poser, man? That shit was whack.
It's time for Hate It or Love It. On Shade 45.
Yes.
Shade 45. Let's go to Detroit with this one. Got Ty Ferris in the D. What's up, Ty?
What's going on?
Shit, chillin'. What part of Detroit you from?
Eastside, 6 Mile.
All right, that's what's up. And how long you been rapping for, Ty?
Man, about 10 years. Man, I done hung out with you, Jude. Man, I was signed with Big Proof under the Purple Gang.
Oh, yeah, shit. All right, how you been, dog? Good to talk to you again.
Good, man. Grinding, you know how it go.
What's it been like? Proof has passed a while ago. What is that transition been like for you?
You know, we had it made when P was here, man. We didn't have to deal with all the politics he dealt with them for us. But now, you know, I had to get out and politic on my own, you know what I'm saying? So it's been a little just an adjustment, but, you know, ain't nothing to it.
All right. Tell us about the song that we're going to play.
The joint, I Promise, featuring the homie Royce from here, you know what I'm saying, off my new project, Rider Music.
All right, bet. All right, well, shit, let's jump off into this. We'll let people know whether they hate it or love it. 888-742-3345.
ride with me. You know the bitches love my charisma. Close your eyes and vibe with me. On the road to riches and diamond rings. Yeah, real niggas do real things. Wait for it, nigga. The vision of a vigilante in the village of violence, gorillas and vipers, drug dealing to get them some diamonds. We live in a riot, minus the sirens, and the victim is dying. Never caught slipping, so I'm gripping the iron. These bullets are cripple a giant, crazy enough to try to tickle a lion. Posted with pistols on McNichols and Ryan, working triples with the sniffles in a cold spot. Running through life's roadblocks, most niggas gon' be here until they soul ride. These the streets that I call home. See homies get carried and buried just like a dog bone. You pushing them keys, huh? Go ahead, get your blog on. For them Jordans that Kevin wear, we break legs and jaw bones. I reckon they show respect once I perfected my craft. Now they mad, cause I'm trying to break their necks and jags. I polish my image, politicking with politicians. An honest living, so see my vision when I'm dropping lyrics. Don't care about the money or fame or fancy chains if I can't hang where I used to
hang. 742-3345 is hey, I love it. 8-8-7-4-2-3-3-4-5 Ty Ferris from Detroit.
I promise I would never change. I promise I would never change. A vigilante with the vision to visit the top. And I'm driven, sipping liquor, living them lyrics from pop. Trying to make my Wallace Christopher Wallace chilling in drops. You Kirk Thomas, 40 years old and you still on the block. I decided to lead a block. My mentality so different from coke sniffing old women thugs with no vision. The only mission is mixing and whipping. Not to mention they killers, sipping millers, drug dealers and young niggas. I ain't changed, I'm the same. Just an artist painting my pain. Van Gogh, let the fans know I'ma stay in my lane. I'm a living legend till I live in heaven. It's a message from my Smith and Wesson. If you disrespect and hear that foul, I promise I'll never turn my back on my homies who was with me eating them conies. Never phony, they know me. So I play my position like I'm Pippin, but I'm Jordan when recording. Until I'm touring, it's a fucking warning and a promise. Don't care about the money or fame or fancy chains. If I can't hang where I used to hang, still claim where I bang at a young age. And now I'm getting paid and still respect my name. I promise I would never change.
Yeah,
I promise I would never change.
Nickel. Now you can find me riding around my city like I own it. Windows up, thinking about my Grammy speech. I'm thinking I'd like to thank my microphone and my cojones for keeping it G, for keeping the baddest chicks to deed and seem weak in the knee. I've been in a couple of scraps on occasion, cause niggas fuck with me then. You never seen me with a scratch on my face, maybe just a cast on my hand. I'll let you use your own deductive reasoning. If you don't see it, you need to focus more. Wife faithful, side bitch is mute cause she's spoken for. I should rock a Pyrex suit, put rocks in each pocket, somersault off of a block of raw and then try to drop to the ocean floor. I'm putting dope in the motion. This time I'm going off. A huge cloud of dust is around me like Brian throwing chalk. I had to put the ice away cause y'all niggas was throwing salt. The best alive, I specialize in spazzing. Only pressure I have is having a pressurized cabin.
Don't kill me, I promise. Money and fame or fancy chains. If I can't hang where I used to hang, still claim where I bang at a young age. And now I'm getting paid, they still respect my name. I promise I would never change. I promise I would never change.
Edit at 742-3345. Yo, Ty, what up, man? You ready to take some calls, see whether people hate it or love it?
Let's get it. Let's get it.
All right, let's go. We got Kenny calling from Cali. Hate or love it, bro?
What's up, man? I'm loving it, man. Anybody that says they hate it, those conform motherfuckers, you know, on the other shit. But, yo, he's all the way live, man. I like this shit.
I appreciate it, man. Appreciate it.
No doubt.
Bam. No doubt, okay, man. Let's go to Marvin in Baltimore. Marvin, what's up?
Hey, now, what up? Yo, that shit was official, man. I love it, man. You can't even get no better. That shit sound better than 80% of the music y'all play.
Damn.
Yeah, man. That shit official right there, man. Okay. One love. Appreciate it.
All right, let's go to Tex Thousand. Is that his name?
Tex Thompson.
Oh, Tex Thompson.
What's up, man? Tex. This is Tex Thompson from Houston. I'm on my come up, too, and I just want to say That might be the best hated or loved I've heard, man. Keep on your grind. That shit is good.
Wow, man. All right. I appreciate it, man.
Let's go to Texas. Jose, what up?
Yo, what's up, man? I love it, man. Put that shit on rotation.
Damn.
Wow.
Bam.
Let's get it.
Look at that. Getting some love, bro. This is, yo, it's not, yo, enjoy this. This does not happen all the fucking time, Ty. Let's go to Bay Bay in Cali.
Yo, man, hey, that shit was dope, dog. I'm an artist, too. I was feeling that shit, bro, real talk.
Good looking, my G, good looking.
No, yeah, you the one, bro. That shit was tight. Put that shit in rotation, for real.
Got him.
Right, let's keep, see if we can keep going. We got Garrett in Wyoming. Hey, to love it, Garrett.
Yo, love it. That shit was fire.
Wow, man, I appreciate
it. Bro, fucking, that's all around the country, you notice, everybody. That's from different spots, fucking Central, fucking Cali, Texas, fucking everywhere. Keep doing it, man. You're doing it big. Going to.
All right, man.
You're 6 for 6. Tyler, right now, you're 6 for 6. If you can go 7 for 7, we'll run it back again. What the hell? Let's go.
Let's do it.
Let's go to pick a line, 1 through 5, bud.
4.
All right, here it is. We got Josh in Nebraska. Hate or love it.
Love it. Love it. Kicking it. It's rocking. Play it again. Play it again.
There you go. Congratulations, Ty. Hey, here's a little secret, Ty. Every it didn't matter what line you picked. They all loved it, Doug.
Yeah, that's love, man. I appreciate y'all showing me the love.
Damn.
Why don't you let everybody know where they can find you, follow you, get the mixtape?
Yeah, the mixtape is on iTunes, Rider Music, and the Twitter is Ty Ferris, T-Y. #1
There it is.
Yeah, man.
There it is.
Rapping the D.
Yeah, got to do it. Appreciate y'all.
So cold.
That's Ty Ferris out there doing that shit.
Damn.
Purple Gang, everybody. Thanks for calling up, Ty, and congratulations on that win. What's your Twitter?
Yeah, Ty Ferris, TYFARRIS1. I just hit you on that, boy, too, Jude.
All right, cool. I'll retweet you then, man.
All right,
that was
Ty.
He won. Hey, I love it. All right, now. Peace.
J45. Go at Tuesday. Yeah, man. Take over this motherfucker.
It's a new year. Symbolic of new beginnings. But you know what, people? Just know this. You can start over anytime you want. That's the beautiful thing about life. You don't have to wait for January 1st for a new beginning. You want a new beginning? In April, you fucking do it, all right? That's my little pep talk.
Damn it, do whatever the fuck you want. Take your shirt off in the studio. Fill yourself up. Do what you want to do.
You should do that right now, Sear. You should take your shirt
Please
off
don't,
when you
Sear.
And Sam in there.
Huh? Do not take your shirt off, Sear.
Come on, man. Why? What's up? Frontin'?
You should do it, Sear. Take off your shirt for Sam.
Do right
Don't
now.
Do it, Sear. Don't do it.
Rub your nipple on the fucking mic.
Put some Kool-Aid on there. Make it lick it up.
You got some Kool-Aid?
I gotta make some. I got.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do gotta make some. All right, so since this is new beginnings and you can do anything you want, like take off your shirt. I wish you would one of these days. You always crack that joke, but I really wish you would just fucking.
Watch.
He be cracking that joke a lot to have his shirt on.
Yeah, look at the calls.
Just be the cool, fat motherfucker with like all types of rolls and shit.
Yeah, I got two rolls. I got two rolls. I ain't got a lot of rolls.
They just real big.
Yeah.
Word. They look like couch cushions.
Well, you know, see what I'm saying? Your mind is mentally challenged, man. You think a lot about. What I have on, what I don't have on. Oh, this is scary.
Yo, hey, I was trying to give people a pep talk. Your ass jumped in with your little take the shirt off joke. So I'm just over here rolling with you, man.
You always adding on.
I'm just over here rolling with you, man. I'm trying to build, man.
All right,
look. All right, so this is new beginnings. So we're going to play you some beginnings. We're going to play you some early shit from some big time artists.
Yes.
Maybe you'll be familiar with it. Maybe you won't. Some people sound totally different than they sound like now. Mm-hmm. Other people, you know, they sound the fucking same. Sear's gonna kick it off with a jazz old Jay-Z joint. Well, tell them a bit about this one, Sear.
Well, this one here is called The Originators. A joint that came out in 1990 off of Jazzo's second album. His first album had Jazzo with Hawaiian Sophie. Jazz was, you know, Jay-Z is Jazzo's DJ.
Yes.
So,
yes.
You know what I'm saying? So, at the time, he was spitting little lyrics, so not crazy. But this one shows his much more lyrical side. And the song is called The Originators because they invented this style that you're about to hear with Jay-Z and Jazzo.
Let's go.
Let's do it right now. 88 Shade 45. Here we go.
They use them same drums on stuff in the arena, huh?
Yes, sir. That's, Fred Wesley and,
Yes.
Yeah, Fred Wesley. They did production with, your boy, Funkadelic.
Funkadelic and all them, yeah.
That's right.
888-742-3345. Yo, that was Jay-Z going, doing all that iggity bitty 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 all that shit.
Yeah, because Jazz on went first, and then Jay-Z went second. Then he was still trying to do diggity 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 until Big L brought him up to our old station on 89 Tech 9, and, you know, God bless, Big L had to kill him with, yeah.
Yep, Big L got him, but then Jay-Z ended up.
Entrepreneurish.
End up being one of the best.
Yeah.
It's not how you start, it's how you finish, people. Remember that shit.
Mm-hmm.
It's not how you start, it's how you finish. It's okay to lose.
And there ain't no hey.
It's what you do afterwards. It's what you do afterwards. And the funny thing is, I was listening to that, and I was thinking, like, man, I think that the way he was rapping so fast, I think it made him be able to rap better slow. Like, he was able
exactly.
to really, like, if you can bust that, if you could bust that quickly, then rapping slow has got to be super easy for you.
And your words are clearer. You make much more sense. Yeah.
Yo, Patience just tweeted me at @rude_Jude. You can follow me there. Patience just tweeted me. I just started a new job and a new commute. Can I please hear some better music than this?
Wow.
This is too much right now. She ain't like that shit.
Oh, wow.
Well, it's not for everybody. I hope maybe you like the older Jay. Maybe you like the newer Jay-Z. And just for that, I think I'm going to play you another joint. Let me find that. Oh, come on. I hope I got it. Yeah, I got it. Here's a little something. Here's some early UGK for you. You didn't like the Jay-Z? Maybe you like this early UGK. This came out before the fucking Pocket Full of Stones and all that shit. This was from the Band EP. And this is one of my favorite little joints. It's called Pregnant Pussy. It's about fucking pregnant chicks.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, pretty awesome.
Let's do it.
So, Patience, I hope that you liked the Pregnant Pussy song better.
Hey.
What's not to like about Pregnant Pussy?
What's
that? The awesome thing is, you can't get her pregnant again. You can just go raw, and then it swells up like a little baboon's ass.
Oh, shit.
It's almost worth getting a chick pregnant just so you can get some pregnant pussy.
Damn.
But not really. No. Unless it's your girl. Unless it's your girl. That was UGK. This is the new beginning. This is the beginning of the year, y'all. New beginnings. We're playing you the beginnings of some of the best. We start off with Jay-Z. That was UGK.
Yes.
Pregnant Pussy off of their Band EP, 888-742-3345. Let's go to Victor in San Antonio.
Hey, man. Am I on?
Yeah, you're on. Let's see.
All right, well... Why do you guys think Jay-Z switched from that style? I mean, that was a pretty tight style, and then he started to sample Nas's voice and you know, his style. Why do you think he went in that direction?
I don't think he sampled Nas's voice.
I don't
you mean like he sampled his voice in that song?
Oh, Dead Presidents.
Yeah, and then, people will tell you that, man, he just jacked Nas' style, and that's it.
Nah, you know who says that? People that think that Ether won. Not even that. Like, Sear thinks that Ether won, but do you think Jay-Z took Nas' style? Nah.
I mean, he definitely has his own
style. Victor, that would be like saying Nas took Rakim's style. Not even. That's not even. Nah, yo, they were contemporaries. They don't sound alike,
Nas,
dude.
Nas will say, you know, Rakim, that Rakim paved that road for Nas, and, you know, that scientific rapping, Nas definitely has that element.
Victor, you sound like a kind of guy that likes to listen to quote unquote intelligent rap, but you're really not smart enough to wrap your head around it, really. But yo, I know that sounded mean, but like this sounds like the argument. Go back and listen to Jay-Z. He doesn't sound like Nas, dude. He just doesn't.
I mean, I like Jay-Z with that album with the devils and those.
He's still going in. I mean,
sometimes I don't hit the fucking hold button quick enough. And the reason why he switched up, because that style sounds dated.
True.
It sounds dated. It sounds like, if you listen to that sound, it sounds like 1992. Sounds like Fushnikins and Das Effects and all that other shit.
Let it go.
There you go. I thought you wanted to talk about Pregnant Pussy and how awesome it was. But fine, we could talk about Jay-Z.
Right.
Actually, speaking of Nas, I'm gonna play you a Nas song. Search put this guy on, and he was fucking with Main Source as well.
Yes.
And he brought him by and got him on the Live at the Barbecue joint off of the Breaking Adams. You gonna say something?
Oh no! Big shout out to Search. Oh. I saw the episode last night. Very positive.
Yeah, Search has a new talk show.
Yes.
We wish you much success. Here it is, Nas doing his thing live at the barbecue, and this was the track that helped get him a little buzz, and then was it halftime, and then It Ain't Hard to Tell, and and the rest is history. Here it is. That's all. Alright, let me just say something, cause this is the shit that kills me, okay?
All right.
And you could weigh in, Sear. And I like Large Professor.
Okay.
But, like, when people diss MC Hammer for being whack, and then, like, yo, Large Professor can't rap, dude. Like, you said, that's a bunch of mamba jabambo. And,
no,
like, why they call me Large Professor? And because I bang a heifer? Like, what the
Listen. He said, that's a bunch of mamba jambo. Like, you know, that's Some old slavery, Mamba Jambo, like whatever they said.
Yeah, still not sweet though.
And then listen. Then he said,
and then the Large Professor and the heifer line.
And then I kept it tucking on the dresser, but you know, Hammer was more like,
I'm not trying to like compare the two. I just, that was the first guy that I remember New Yorkers would shit on, but I just, and Large Professor is an awesome producer. But you guys, they, back in the day, they were very selective about the way they would critique rappers. Like, that shit got a pass. You know what I mean? Like, I'm like, come on, dude.
I mean, to tell you the truth, I didn't think Lars wasn't the greatest, but Lars did say some dope shit. Like, you know, when we're no downtown, what was that shit?
With Lars Professor. You know, don't give me, I like Lars Professor. I'm just saying, that was not one of his most shining moments. That's all. That's all I'm saying. Why they call me the Large Professor? Because I milk a heifer. Like, what the fuck does that have to do with being a Large Professor?
Because I milk the cow. That's a lot.
Shout out to Large Professor.
He's
come by the show.
Yeah, he's going to come out and do a set soon. He wants to come up and do a set for the All Out show. Shout out to Young Guru. I'm on the check-in, and I'm going to have him come up and do a set, too. Jay-Z's producer.
Fuck yeah, dog.
Yes, sir.
Actually, yo, is Young Guru listening right now? Is he listening
now? Yesterday. I saw him yesterday, and wants to do it.
Oh, yeah. I would, like, fuck a set. I want to sit down and hear him talk about some...
We could definitely have him build up, yeah.
Let's just have him go through some tracks. Let's go through some Jay-Z tracks. He can tell us about how he did them.
Yes,
I would love to hear that.
Yes, sir.
Dottie G in Texas, what's up?
Yeah, man, and tell Guru to tell us about how Jay-Z sounds like Nas and shit. What the fuck that white boy talking about, bro? No offense, Drew. No offense, Jude. No offense. But you know what I mean?
He wasn't white. That cat was Latino. Don't try to put that shit on us.
Oh, man. Well, I don't know what the fuck he was talking. He was on Xanax and fucked up. He think that dumbass shit, bro. Like, I don't know. Nas did sound like Rakim when he first came out, but everybody sounded like somebody when they first came out in their little time of era or whatever they were rapping about. But
come on, man. Like Jay-Z, bro. And the other, like,
you know what they sounded like when they came out? They sounded like their time. If you listen to that, if you listen to Nas come on there, he sounded like 1992. They just sound like what they've been around. They sound like the style of music, you know.
Yeah, and then later on, you know, artist finds himself, he finds his own style and he sticks to it. You know what I mean? And that's what Hova did. I don't understand how he feels that way, bro. Like that don't make no fucking sense. But anyway, bro, man, shout out to you playing that Pimp C shit. You know what I mean? Long live the pimp, licking assholes and snorting cocaine off titties. You know what I mean? Rest in peace.
All that. That's Dottie G. Licking assholes.
Yeah, okay.
Snorting cocaine off of titties. Peace. Woo. Let's go to Jay and Callie. Go ahead, Jay.
Jill, what's going on, man? I wanted to make a couple of statements. I kind of wanted to ask you a question. Do you think that E-40, the way he used to rap on Mr. Flamboyant, do you think he stopped rapping like that because that was a dated style? And also, I also wanted to make a comment. I think that the third bass song, Gas Face, I think that's what ended Hammer's career. And then after that, all kind of New York rappers started jumping on Hammer and things like that. And I think people thought that when a Tribe Called Quest said, what you think, Hammer, proper, rap is not pop. If you think that, then stop. I think that they thought that I can't remember what his name is right now. But I think that people thought that he was clowning Hammer. But he wasn't. He was just saying. And after that, Hammer's whole career just went downhill, you know, like.
Happened to Hammer? What happened to Hammer was too many white people started liking him, and then it. In the day, if too many white people started liking you, that meant there had to been something wrong with your music. So, like, when your mom is claiming Hammer, and you're like some 15-year-old kid, and you're like, fuck you, mom, I don't want... And she's like, if she's claiming Can't Touch This, that's when you walk away from it.
But he did come back and made Pumps and a Bump.
Bro, we should play some of that first... That first Hammer tape was my shit back in the day, dude. That first Hammer tape was the shit. I fucking loved Hammer. And everybody in my neighborhood. I love E-40.
Do you think that style of rap where he was rapping real fast, do you think that, because I never heard that word used with fast rap, dated. So do you think that he stopped doing that because that was a dated style?
I think people just naturally progress and then it naturally, I think people grow. I think he rapped different because he got a different style. You know, that's it. You just grow. You come into your own as a rapper. And I'll see if I got that Mr. Flamboyant in here. Yeah, we haven't even gone to the West Coast for that. Yeah. Let's see. I want to see if I got any old E-40 on this computer.
Okay. Yeah, man.
Oh, shit. Hold on. Oh, wait, no.
Movies, man.
What's that?
Three Strikes. E-40 was in a lot of movies.
Here's like some old shit right here. This is some old Mr. Flamboyant shit that he was just speaking on. This is early E-40. This is early right here.
Yeah.
I'm just a hustler on the go. If you know it, sing along. Hold on, I'm gonna bring it back. If you know, I'm just a hustler on the go. We taking you way back. Don't act like we don't know about it, bruh. Sear and I are well-versed. I don't even want to pat ourselves on the back, but, bruh, we'll take you back, bruh.
Shit, like a motherfucking headline.
Yeah, I'm just a hustler.
I like this joint of Sam, man, dude. I like this.
Yeah, I'm just a hustler on the go.
888-742-3345. It's the beginning of the year. We're playing Beginnings of Careers. You like that? It's the beginning of the year, and we're playing Beginnings of Careers.
Wait, but you just thought about that right now?
What's that?
You just thought about that right there, right now?
Talking about what?
The careers.
Yeah, these are all the beginnings. Yeah, these are all the beginnings of these rappers' careers. That's E-40 and the Click, Mr. Flamboyant right there. From way back in the day.
I took the guy and then the Public Enemy with the hood. Yes.
Yeah. Edit 8742-3345. We got Tavares. What up, man?
What up, y'all? What up, man? Good looking on that 40, man. That Mr. Flamboyant really set the tone in the Bay, man, back in the day. No doubt about it. But you know who also did that damn thing from Jump was Short Dog, man. That Born to Mac cassette tape.
Mm. Let me
that
see if
was
I got
the
that
one.
On computer.
See, if you got the, he had a joint there called I Need a Freak. That shit had the town completely fucked up.
that was my first dose of like hip hop music back when I was a young dude. My brother brought that shit down. He was from Sacramento. I heard that joint. It was a rap. It was over.
Let's see. That Born to Mac. Did it have Dope Fiend Beat and shit on there?
Dope Fiend Beats was on that shit. I think it's the joint where he on the front. It's like a blue backdrop. And just says, Too Short, Born to Mac. I think he's sitting like in a Raider Derby with a gold chain on.
Yeah.
But y'all doing your fucking video. This ain't 4-5. Y'all show is hot, man.
Thank you.
You ain't know? Yeah. You ain't know shit. You better tell these motherfuckers. Too. You better tell them, man. You better let them know, bro. Yeah.
Y'all
well, welcome to
funny,
listen.
Man. Say 4-5. Stand up. That's what it is, man. Bay Area in the building. Fuck all them haters, baby.
To virus rapping. Go ahead, man. Yo. Y'all. Yo. What up, though? We got a let's go to Rude Ross in the D. What up, though?
What up, though? True.
Shit. What up, man?
Hey, y'all should play some of that Spice One.
That would be a good ass idea. Let me see if I can find some Spice for y'all cats too. There's a. Yeah, where at?
In Detroit at Hard Plaza when you was with some fine ass little light skinned chick.
That's what's up. Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Was she taller? I'm trying to think.
Hard Plaza. This was years ago, man. This was like shit, probably like 18 years ago, bro.
Damn.
Fuck. All right, shit. Yeah. Okay, yeah. A little red bone, little. Was she taller?
A little tall, skinny thing. She was tight, though.
Yeah. She was from the west side. Yeah, she was dope. She was from the west side, man. Yeah. That's a minute ago, man. So, fuck.
Yeah. I fuck with y'all, man. Y'all be having the pumping over there.
Pumping.
Always. Always.
What up, right. Yeah, what up?
All right. I'm off.
Fucker.
Peace.
Motherfucker.
Mike in Syracuse, what up, man?
Yeah, yo, Jude, let me tell you, it's their excellent show. I'm glad you give me something to listen to. I laugh my balls off when I listen to you guys.
Awesome.
That dude, I called you for something good, but let me just tell you that dude that said Jay-Z and Nas, they sound the same. I don't know what the fuck he's listening to. That's just some bullshit right there. They just don't sound the same. Just never did sound the same. And they never will sound the same.
Bro, that's just somebody that, like, is, you know, it's just somebody that believes some propaganda that was out there during the whole battle.
It's just some ignorant kid sitting, where was he, in Texas, wherever the fuck he was. He's just some ignorant fucking kid, doesn't know nothing, you know, whatever.
Well, let's not beat him up here. Let's not beat him up and just keep it moving. What did you want to say something about liking pregnant pussy?
Listen, first, I did, but let me say, who answers your phone there?
Buddy, just stay on fucking topic, man. Just stay on topic.
I apologize to her for telling her that's what I called for. Let me just tell her I'm sorry that I told her that, you know, why I was calling. But yes, pregnant pussy is the best pussy in the world. I got a pregnancy fetish. I get my balls busted for it because you just see a hot looking broad slamming body and that baby bump coming out. And then if you're lucky enough to get in bed with her, it is the wettest pussy, the most, it just no feeling like it in the world. You ever had pregnant pussy?
Yeah.
Tastes
well,
good.
I got a baby mama, so yeah, I've had some, yeah, it's awesome.
Oh my God.
It is awesome. It's really fun. I feel you. I think I lasted 2 minutes in it. What's that?
Exactly. They either don't want to fuck because they're pissy, or that's all they want to do is fuck.
There it is.
Nope. All right.
Thanks. Thank you for that call. There was ups and there was downs to that motherfucking call. Yo, let's go to Sean in Cleveland. Sean.
What's up, fellas?
What up, though, man?
Hey, man. I just caught the end of your conversation because I just got in the car, and I heard you say something about MC Hammer went out because white people like this music. I mean, MC Hammer's music changed. He was no different than Vanilla Ice. He was no different than Nas. And I have to comment and say, Jay-Z and Nas did not sound alike. Music style was a little bit there, but you know, that was that East Coast era there. But, I mean, I a lot of white people, me growing up, you know, I'm 42 now. Man, hip-hop was my shit.
You're misunderstanding me, buddy.
Shit.
No, but Sean, you're misunderstanding
me.
No, yeah, you are. You are misunderstanding me because you're rambling right now. So I hope you're misunderstanding me or you're just fucking drunk. One of the two. What I was saying is, all right, well, then you're not understanding. All I'm saying is, we need to shut the fuck up and play some music. Ain't that right, Robert?
Can we get
Ain't that fucking right? These motherfuckers, ain't that right? Let's shut the fuck up and play some goddamn music.
This is popping, my dude.
Let's play some motherfucking music. I'm gonna play some Early Hammer. Just a little joint call. Let's get it started. I can do this. Yo, it's the beginning of the year. It's Takeover Tuesday, and this we are playing you the beginning of careers here on Shade 45. I'm gonna end it with "Money Gone" by Spice One. Since fuck it, my man from the D caught up, wanted to hear some Spice One. Said he met me back in the day with a red bone. So you get back in the day credit on that one, buddy. You anything you want to add there, Sear?
I want to add that you just had me dancing just now doing the hammer.
Let's get it started. All right, there's a little joint called Money Gone. Now, yo, bae, we looked out for y'all at the tail end of this shit, didn't we, there, Bay Area? Here it is. All right, man, that was it. Coming up next, we're going to do, we got next hour news from the throat, Psychic Friends Hotline. What is it, Psychic? What the fuck is the name of our psychic shit?
It's the Psychic Hotline, but you keep calling it the Friends Network, so.
I think that was the name of that shit back in the day, right?
It was not Shakespeare. No, the Friends
Network. I never heard that.
Psychic Friends Network.
Yeah.
I'm going to look that shit. I'm going to Google that shit right now. I think that was some real shit. Psychic Friends.
But it could be whatever you want it to be, Jude.
Thanks, Sam. Thanks for letting it be whatever I want it to be.
What about me?
What do you want it to be, Sear?
This space music coming right back. I'm going to let you know.
You don't know? All right. We'll call it what you had it. We're calling it then, Sam.
Okay. The Psychic Hotline.
What is it called?
Psychic Hotline.
Psychic Hotline. I swear to God, it was, you don't remember them commercials, it was like the Psychic Friends Network, and then they would call up, maybe I'm wrong, sometimes I make up shit in my head, fuck it. Also, hey, I wrote a book, you should read that book, you should buy that book, you should learn to read, if you're not a big reader, this is the perfect book for you. If you can't read, this is the perfect book for you to start reading. Do you want to get inside of the head of Jude Angelini? Are you ready for that shit? Are you ready for what's going on in this fucking cranium?
Uh-oh.
The book is Hyena. It's out. It's doing well. And it's doing well because of y'all. So I want to shout out everybody that's been copping it. And if you haven't bought it, you need to buy that shit. Because you think you know Jude, but you don't even know a little bit about Jude. Not even a touch. Shit goes crazy. Hyena, it's out on Amazon and other fine book places. Call up your local bookstore and see if they have Hyena. If not, you can just get it off of Amazon. Fuck it. So whoop, there it is. The Jamaican had the Psychic Friends Network. Thank you. I remember Miss Cleo asked. Yeah, I knew that shit. Thanks, Cheesy Switch.
I knew Miss Cleo, but I didn't know that's what it was called.
Well, now you do know. It's a Psychic Friends, motherfucker.
So are we going with that name?
Oh, wait, no, wait. Dionne Warwick had the psychic that had a network, and the Jamaican had the Miss Cleo ass.
Yeah.
I forgot about her old fucking, that beige Jamaican motherfucking with the do-rag.
Hello, Miss Cleo.
All right, man. Let's play some. What you got up next there to play for us?
Some Jeezy.
Little Jeezy. Heard he got. Didn't he get in trouble for whooping his kid's ass or something?
Yeah,
like
that will be in the news in a little bit.
Look at that. That's called a teaser. We'll tell you more about that. Don't go anywhere.
I was in the dark until I called
888 Shade 45.
Now I know my past, present, and my future. You can too.
Call the healer.
Lord Spirit, nigga!
question answers. Do you have a question that needs to be answered?
Yes.
Call up 888-742-3345 and talk to two psychic healers. Yes. I'm the healer.
I'm just the psychic.
And that's... What's your name? Tell them your name, your psychic name.
Spirits.
Lord Spirit.
I can give you guidance. Make you feel good about yourself.
Question about your future.
Yes.
Question about your past. Question about your lover. Question about your friend. Call up right now, 888-742-3345, and talk to two bona fide psychics. Wait, I can feel someone calling right now.
Uh-oh.
The phone lines are lit up. Let's play a psychic song and come back with the psychic network.
That's
on J45.
Put the needle on the record, man.
Psychic network. Chakra. Do you have a question? You need to talk to a psychic? Well, you have two psychics here to talk to you for free. The healer.
Yes.
In Lord Spirit.
Spirit.
Clairvoyant.
Oh my God.
888-742-3345. Let's go to Joe in Orlando. At least that's what my psychic powers are telling me. Is your name Joe?
Yeah.
Are you in Orlando?
Yeah. Oh
my God, I'm psychic. Oh, I sense problems brewing. What is your psychic question?
Well, I want to know if my girl's cheating on me.
Oh, you want to know if your girl's cheating on you? What do the spirits say? Talking to the spirits right now, they told me they see your girlfriend. This is all symbolic, too. Just your girlfriend putting dick flavored chapstick on, but it's not Joe's dick, it's someone else's dick.
Oh.
All up in her fucking mouth. Oh, she's eating the chapstick.
Oh, that little dirty slut.
And now they're taking the chapstick out and putting it in her vagina. Now they're putting it back in her mouth.
Oh, that's strawberry shortcake.
Could that chapstick be someone else's dick? Probably. Premonition.
Doesn't that be?
I think it is. I see her banging a basketball player.
Oh, shit.
Spirit. I see her pussy fitting a little bit different than it used to, didn't it? It used to fit like a glove. Now it's a little loose inside.
Yeah, like it was a little loose last time I was in there.
That's right, it was a little loose, and you're telling yourself maybe it's just that time of the month. Yeah, it's that time of the month. It's that time of the month that she's fucking a basketball player.
Spirits.
Lord Spirit, what do you see?
I see a big black guy coming out the bathroom, grabbing this chick by the hair.
You know who this is, Lord Spirit?
Yes, it's her.
I was banging your mom the other day.
I do not recall that being funny.
You didn't sense that?
Because that is not funny.
Alrighty. Let's go to David and Callie. David.
How you doing? I wanted to figure out, my girlfriend had told me we're having a kid, so I want to know if it's going to be a boy or a girl.
Ooh, I see. I think you're going to have a boy. I see a boy. But he's gonna have a mad little dick.
Aww.
Like a baby-sized dick.
Okay. Like when he's grown up or just coming out, he's just going to have a little dick.
No, just when he's a baby. It'll be, okay. I see it growing to regular average size once he gets to be a teenager.
Average white male, sounds good.
Yeah, but yeah, he's definitely going to have a little dick when he's born. Like under 3 inches.
Oh, why are you playing me like that?
What do you see, Lord Spirit?
I see the baby looking very disgustingly ugly. Peeing on himself when he keeps looking in the mirror and does not understand why I have a father named David. It should be David.
Y'all playing me right now, but thank you. I'm hoping.
You're welcome. Okay. Oh, I'm going to go to line two. Hello. Hello, sir. Does your name have something to do with working at McDonald's?
Nah.
Is your name Calvin?
Yeah. Damn. Alright, I got a question for Jude. I don't want to hear shit from Lord Spit. Whatever.
Okay, bitch.
I want to know, honestly, if Lord Spit is going to lose his baby fat this year.
Oh, yes. He will lose his baby fat. Yes. Unfortunately, he still has his adolescent fat, his grown-up fat, his middle-aged fat.
Yes. My old fat.
His prepubescent fat.
Yeah.
So, there it is.
And Calvin should have my fat in his face and fall on it.
Get your ass out of here.
Goodbye, Calvin. Go back to McDonald's.
Psychic. Premonition. Oh, this. I see an animal name.
Yeah.
A fucking animal name in Dallas. Hello, who is this?
BK Rabbit? Hello?
Is this BK Rabbit? Okay, yes, alright. My psychic powers are working. I'm the healer.
BK Rabbit.
Alright, BK Rabbit, what is your question?
I'm just wondering why I can't bang the hot girls, man. It's always something else.
Why can't you bang the hot girls? Ooh, I see a ugly motherfucker with no game on the other line.
No, man, actually, I'm pretty good looking, man.
Your name is a
rabbit. Probably thinks he's way better looking than he is.
You're a rabbit.
I see him with a good job and still can't bag a hot chick.
Well, everything stopped after Thanksgiving. But it was just like the bigger ones before that and all the crazy exes. Trying to see what the problem is.
Oh, this is what I feel. I feel someone put a mojo on you, BK Rabbit.
I've had all this bad luck.
Yes, yes. That's some a mad lover, a jealous ex-lover put a mojo on your dick. This is what you're going to have to do to break this mojo. You're going to have to go jerk off under the tree on a full moon.
Christmas tree?
No, just like an oak or an elm.
Oh, awesome. Well, what
crab tree, crab
one?
Apple.
I'm pretty sure.
Jerk
pretty
off
sure
in your hand.
Of these girls.
Well, this I'm helping you. Just
shut up.
You just jerk off and you finish in your hand and then you rub it all over your face. And then you eat a hot dog with relish on it. And your mojo will be broken.
And pixie dust. We'll sprinkle that on the hot dog. Maybe
that's
that'll
help.
No,
that's not. What do you think, Lord Spirit?
I think he should change his name.
I have to put the hot dog in the sock, man, because that shit ain't going in my face.
Something should go in your face. Like a pig's dick. Should put it in your ear and clean out the wax. Just put the pig dick right in your ear. Clean out the wax. Thank you.
Mystic.
Yep.
Hi.
Hello. We're in New York. Hello. Who is this? Do you got a real fucked up sounding name? Hello.
Yeah, hello.
What up?
Do you have a name or you a woman?
It's Shakezilla.
Oh, Shakezilla.
Who?
Oh, Lord Sear, what's good?
What is your psychic question, sir?
Oh? Where did he go? Hung up the phone. Shasira, Shakila, why did you leave the network?
Hello, is this... Do you have the name of someone with a man throat? Hello? Yes, yes. Hello, who is this?
This is Sam speaking.
Okay, yes, you have a man throat name. Okay, what is your question?
My question is, I smoked something in Asia 2 years ago, and I haven't come down yet, so what the fuck's going on?
You smoked some dust, bro.
Did I?
You got dusted.
I got PCP'd?
You smoked some sherm.
They peed in it, and you smoked it also.
Was it Asian pee?
No, it was...
Were you in Asia, dickhead?
I was in Japan. What so it was Japanese pee. It was sushi
fucking,
pee.
Yeah.
Fucking...
Fuck. So am I fucked?
That was the Psychic Friends Network.
Yes.
Let's go. Let's end with El Boogie. Okay. El Boogie, hello? The last one. Hello, El Boogie.
Hey, how you doing, psychic guys?
Hey.
I wanted to ask a question. I've been running into a lot of fat girls. I want to know if the psychics see me getting a fat girl around tax time to get some money out of them.
I see you. Ooh. I see a blonde-haired girl smoking Newports, frying you a bologna sandwich.
With cheese? Dang. No cheese?
Fuck yeah, with cheese. Who the fuck wouldn't have a bologna sandwich with cheese?
All right.
American cheese.
It looked like she was on
some toasted white bread with some mayonnaise. Miracle.
Oh, fuck. No.
Yes. Ooh, I see you. I see you giving her all your dick, but...
Wow.
She's so fat that she's still missing out 2 inches of it.
Oh, my God. That's a gun. How big is
it? I see her barely fitting into her probe.
What the fuck? Fucking pro.
I see her eating ice cream from the gallon and claiming a thyroid problem.
No oral, right? I don't have to eat no pussy, do I?
Ooh, I see her being grateful just that she's getting some dick, so you're not gonna have to eat anything.
Oh my God. She'll do all the eating. Thank you. This sounds fat as fuck.
What do you see?
Is this one of Sears old bitches? Lord Spirit?
Spirit, what I... She's,
I don't see Sear getting any bitches. To have an old bitch.
It's always the white, hairy ones. Who is just tired. And being around. And looking at themselves in the mirror. Playing with their gray nails. But the girl that you're seeing, she got raped in Glee. And
what?
The girl you're going to have, she got raped in Glee. And she's gonna be eating a can of sweet corn out the can.
sweet corn. The fuck?
In the snow. Putting it on her nipples. You will be licking them off.
Sweet corn, it's okay.
Yes. It's about survival.
Do you see how much money she's giving me?
She'll be giving you $5 and coupons.
Oh, fuck that.
Yes.
Fuck no, it's tax time. No.
You
I
be
see getting half her paycheck.
Yes.
Okay. Good. Cool.
I see her loaning it to you.
Oh, she's
but
like
you never paying her back. Oh yeah, I see her loaning it to you to put on your phone bill and you never paying her back.
No, it's not gonna happen.
Have fun, El Boogie. It was the psychic. Network. Yes. Coming up next, it's News from the Throat.
Yeah, right.
And now, it's Sam with the News from the Throat.
Well, guys, in the news today, there's a new study saying that nearly half of black males by the age of 23 have been arrested.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't mean to sound like a fucking asshole here, but mm-hmm. nearly half of black males by age 23 have been arrested?
Yes.
Isn't that like everybody though? Like, hasn't everybody been arrested by age 23?
Well,
like, what the fuck are you doing if you haven't been arrested by age 23, you bitch?
Damn.
What's going on in your life if you haven't been arrested? What are you doing, you fucking leave it to beaver ass, fucking play it by the rules, fucking fuck boy?
Well, in comparison, Jude, by age 23, 44% of Hispanic males and only 38% of white males have been arrested.
All right, so it's only 6% lower every time, basically.
Basically,
you like the
yeah.
way I did that math, fucking Asian chick? You like that shit? You think you're the only math motherfucker in this bitch?
Well, your math is wrong. Well, it would
fucking all Rain Man on you. What's 38 plus 12?
What's 38 plus 12 is 50.
Ooh. Yeah, fucking man. Throat, didn't you just say half?
I said nearly half, but I should have specified it was 49%. Semantics. But if you were going by the 50% thing, you would have been correct, dude. I'm glad that you can subtract 44 from 50. Congratulations.
Wow.
But did you see it at the speed I did that shit?
I guess. I mean,
all right, but what's crazy is... Well, I'm still. Let's not beat up what I just did. My accomplishment. I think it was pretty fucking good.
All right, it was good.
I don't think everybody in this room could have done that.
I know. I was just gonna say.
I would have edited mad faster. You know what I'm saying? I like 2 + 2.
Sear, what's 44 minus 38? Quick.
Like 11 something.
Let me help you out, Sear. I'll help it so Sear can understand. If you got 22 donuts and you add another 14 bottles of beer, how much food do you have?
Damn. I forgot.
36 food, Sir. You have 36 food.
For real? Who cares?
I don't know. That's all right. I guess that's, you know. I thought everybody got arrested at like I thought everybody I know got arrested.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, damn, I know, I got arrested around that time.
Have you been arrested, Sam? Sam,
I haven't been arrested. No,
that's because you're not a man. You just have a man throat.
Fuck you, dude. I'm not a man, and I'm also not black, and I'm not Hispanic, and I'm not white.
That's right. How many Asian motherfuckers been arrested? I bet you like 7.
Well, that is not even reported on this report, so I'm guessing
what did they get arrested for? Illegal karate?
What? Oh, rest in peace to Run Shaw.
What?
Rest in peace to Run Shaw, who made all the karate movies.
Yeah, there you go. Bam. Rest in peace to Run Shaw. What else is in the news, Sam?
Also in the news, I have 9 reasons to date a drama-free woman, Jude.
9 reasons?
Yeah. You want to hear them?
That's the dumbest shit ever. Oh, yeah. Let me hear the 9 reasons why you shouldn't date a drama-free woman.
Number 1, you love being around her positive energy.
A drama-free? This is a chick that doesn't have... I don't know if I'd want to be around a fucking positive bitch every goddamn day. Because some days you just want to get up and not do shit. And if I got to see this motherfucking girl going on nature hikes and yoga and all the time, I'm going to resent her ass. All right, keep going.
We have walnut slurpees.
Number 2, you feel inspired to be a better man.
I'm already a better fucking man. Like, what does that mean? Like, stop doing drugs or something? This is sound. I don't know about this drama-free bitch shit. All right, what is the next one?
Number 3, there are no games, quote-unquote.
All right, that's cool. I like that. I like that. I can't even knock that. I don't want no. Who wants to play games at my age?
Yeah, I'm old.
Look at my hairline. I don't want no games. I just want some real shit.
Look at my belly.
Real love.
Look at my belly. It's tight.
I'm searching for real love. Someone to suck this pink dick. Real love. Oh, searching for a real love.
I know you can sing, boy.
Thank you, man. What's another reason why you shouldn't date a drama? Like, who the fuck? Okay. this is like why you shouldn't get AIDS. You know what I mean? Like, why you shouldn't try to butt fuck a lion? Like, nine reasons. Like, this is, like, of course you shouldn't date a fucking drama-free bitch. You should date a drama-free bitch. All right, go ahead.
Well,
what's another reason?
You'll love number four. Number four is she is happy. That is it.
Just a happy chick.
Yep.
All right, great. Okay, awesome.
Number five.
They could only come up with nine reasons too. Like that's as good as you can do. All right.
Number five. She is open to try new things.
She's open to try new things.
Yeah, like
yeah.
She likes to explore, learn, grow. Yeah.
Like let me and my homeboy fuck her. Woo! Right? New
Maybe.
Shit.
Maybe.
Yeah. Like toss my salad while I got a fucking.
You've been talking about tossing salad this week, man. What's going on here?
Yeah, I'm the toss salad man. I'm the toss salad man. TSM.
Oh, shit, BB.
Like, let me blow fucking, like, let me put crushed up Percocet up her booty.
Sniff it out.
And then have sex with her.
Oh, shit.
New things.
There
what
you
else?
Go. Number six, she believes in you.
She believes in you.
Yeah, like she'll always support you.
How do you know that? How do you know that a drama-free bitch believes in you?
I don't know. I didn't come up with this list.
This is some dumbass shit, because I see a lot of, like, drama-free bitches going to see their bum-ass boyfriends at, like, rap shows that no one goes to. And you know deep down in her heart that she doesn't believe in him. She's just waiting for him to fucking give up on his dream and go get a job at the post office like a normal motherfucker.
Hey, you know what? Let's go to the spot. It has black soap, incense. We get inside. They have free smoothies. Yeah.
She just wants to start having some kids. She's like, as soon as this motherfucker realizes that no one's going to buy his fucking tape, he can go get a job at the post office and give me some fucking babies.
And stay home.
What else?
Also, number seven.
List.
Number seven is she has her own life but wants to share it with you.
Who wrote this? I want to piss in their face. Next.
Antoinette Cabrel wrote this article.
Yeah, that's so lame, dumb bitch. All right, what else?
Number eight, she asks for what she wants and needs.
What?
Okay, that's cool. That's communication is important.
Mm-hmm. All right. And number nine, she is doing great things in her life.
Just because motherfucker ain't got no drama doesn't mean they're doing awesome shit. She might just be like a drama-free waitress. And she can bring me some drama-free ketchup. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't... Mm. And, like, look at half of these motherfucking female pop stars. You know they're crazy as shit, and they're doing awesome stuff in life.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I bet you Lady Gaga is a motherfucking handful to deal with.
Please. Bitch wearing beef. On stage?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That bitch showed up wearing cold cuts and shit. Wearing steak to the motherfucking festival. Like, you can't do that. Like, normal people don't wear steak to the motherfucking party.
Look at steak tartare chain.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
Is that all?
That was the whole list.
Well, thanks for that, Sam. I really appreciate that.
You're
What's
welcome.
Coming up next? Is there more?
Well, there's more stories,
is there more news?
But...
Jesus Christ. Why would you put that in the middle? Why don't you end with the fucking... Why would you put a nine fucking thing list in the middle? What's this other story?
I don't know why I would do that. Quickly, another story is overpraising may do more harm than good to low self-esteems.
All right.
A set of three studies found two correlated phenomena. For starters, they found that parents were more likely to offer excessive or inflated praise to children that were identified to have low self-esteem. And a related study found that after receiving the inflated praise, children with low self-esteem were less likely to step up to new challenges.
Mm.
This is what it is. It's like they look at their little kid and they see that they could be like a loser or some shit like that. So they trying to champ them up. Like, yeah, no, you really colored the fuck out of that picture. And like the picture still look like shit. It's all outside the lines. He made the motherfucking bear pink and brown. And like the kid can look and see that the picture is a piece of shit. You know what I mean? He can look at his picture and then look at Disney and be like, my shit does not look anything like this Disney. And now my mom is lying to me, and it's going to make him feel even worse. That's why you just got to be like, yo, I like what you do with that pink and brown. Maybe you should not do that next time and try to stay in the lines.
Why? Do that? Thank you, mama.
And then the child will respect that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then when he really does do something awesome, he'll know.
True.
Is there anything else?
There is one more thing in the news. As promised from before...
How did you come up with this fucking order? What did you do? Just throw it in a hat and then any way it came out?
I've been spending too much time with Sear.
Yay.
Oh, throwing Sear under the bus. You
it's
like
rubbing
that?
Off.
Just blame Sear.
Leave me
alone. All right,
alone.
Go ahead.
Well, Jeezy was arrested on battery, false imprisonment, and terroristic threats charges.
Not a
terroristic threats.
Yeah, he turned himself in after an alleged fight with his son in 2012.
His son told on him from 2012?
Yeah, and then there was a
That's
warrant
gay
issued.
As fuck.
Yep.
Dude, calling the cops on your old man for a fight is some bitch shit. That and that's Jeezy's son?
Yeah.
The snowman? Son. He raised a kid that calls the cops on his dad?
That ain't good luck. That's not
That's
a good
gay
look.
As fuck, man. You don't call the cops on your fucking mom or dad, dude. You just don't.
Nope. During the fight, Jeezy reportedly threw his son into a glass shower door, causing harm to his son's head. He allegedly punched his son in the face and dragged him into a bedroom where they reportedly continued their fight. And then he choked his son and said, I will kill you. He
and
said,
then what happened?
Well, it says he continued, I will put a bullet in your head right now, and if I could get away with it, I would kill you.
So then his son was like, oh, I'm gonna tell. How old was the kid? Was he like 7? Like, if the kid was 7, that's not cool. How old was the kid?
It doesn't say here.
Can we find out all of the news story? Because I'm gonna feel like a real dick if it was like a 4-year-old he did this shit to.
No, it had to be a
and I'm
wrong
calling him
kid.
Gay and all that shit. But if like if this kid can ejaculate, then fuck this kid, man.
Had to be a grown kid. To do
if he can ejaculate, then fuck him.
He can do a fight.
If it's before his nuts dropped, it's not cool to fucking throw your kid's head into shit. I remember my dad roughing me up before, but like, what was I gonna do? Calling the cops was the last thing I was thinking of, dude. These kids nowadays, fucking giant vaginas.
Yo, it's sure you had to be like 12, 13, 14.
Really, people, don't call the cops on your parents. It's tacky and gay. That's some white people shit. Just, come on. That's one of the things we're not proud of. That and slavery.
Oh, motherfucker, right.
But mayonnaise, I claim the fuck out of that.
The son's name and age have not been identified.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well... Like I said, all right, let's play some music and come on back.
And come on back. That was the news.
You know what?
Let's do this real quick, man. You know what I'm saying? Let's go to phone lines and see who's out there. Talk to some people, man. You know what I mean? And I got some music back here. It's live and bad, baby. Hey. Shade 45. Who's on the phone lines right here? Line one, you live on the air.
This is Big Profit, son.
Hello?
Come on, yo.
Hello, who's this?
It's Profit, man.
What's going on, man? What you sipping on, fool?
Some perp in my cup. About to go send it in on the Suns there. Send it in on the Suns tonight. You want to cake up? Cake up or fake up? All right.
Shout out to my man Dalton, who set that whole situation straight. Shade 45, what's going on?
Hello?
Turn your radio down, bro. Got your radio turned down? What up, man? Hello?
Hello?
What you sipping on, fool?
What's happening, Sid? It's El Boogie, fool.
El Boogie, what up, man?
What's up, my nigga?
Hey, Sid, nigga, how long, man? How long been, man?
Yeah, Happy New Year, my nigga.
Happy New Year, them too, my nigga. What's good?
Shit, man, I'm chilling, man. I'm about to, I'm over this road right now. I'm down here in Tennessee. Tennessee, goddamn it. I'm gonna get through driving. I got this little pint of 1738, you know, shut down shit.
I know, nigga.
I take that shut down shit with me everywhere. You know, I grab me a little pint of that. Let's get a little swerve. Get my little swerve on.
Yeah, but thing. You know, is that good for that weather out there right now? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Nah, it keeps you warm, goddammit.
Mm-hmm. And it's good for the hoes, too.
Hell yeah, they like that shit, that top shelf cognac.
Well, my nigga, you be safe, man. Don't hurt nobody, man.
All right, my nigga, I'm going to get this money. That's all I'm on right now.
That's how you do it, man.
All right.
My nigga, Shade 45. You live on the air, what you sipping on?
What up, sitting in the seat. Sipping on some Henny.
All right, all right. Where you going? You
know, keep... New York, man, it's cold as a bitch out here.
Oh, it's too goddamn cold, man.
Hell yeah, keeping me warm and tired with that honey, man.
All right, that's what's up. Shade 45, what you sipping on?
Sipping on Bush Light in Charleston, South Carolina.
All right, that's what's up. Shade 45, what you sipping on?
Man, I'm feeling good.
Okay, what you sipping on?
I'm about to be sipping on some Chick-fil-A.
Oh, my God, you fucking serious. Hello?
Hey, what's going on, Lord Sear? What's going on?
What up, homie? What you sipping on, man?
Man, I got this Crown Royal Reserve with some Coke.
Oh, man, ain't nothing wrong with that. Can you pour him a drink, please?
Oh, yeah, man. Got your glass waiting right here for you, man.
God damn it. That's what I'm talking about, man. You know what? Let me turn this up a little bit. It's that flavor.